Gaurang Shah here from Geojit. So we did manage to surpass 11,250, 11,300 hurdle on the Nifty spot. And yesterday we were trading quite smartly until the second half, when we saw a little bit of, you know, profit booking and correction coming. And mind you, this was especially after the news came in that supposedly Russia has found a vaccine for the COVID-19. Whereas Europe was trading with much positivity, our markets did give off a little bit. And this morning when we have opened up, we did open with a little bit of downward move, but we have recovered from the lows that we have seen in the opening part in the morning. Overall, the sense remains that this is a buy on dips market. That is what I have been recommending for a long time, and I continue to do that even for this week. Despite the fact that we've opened up with a little bit of weakness, I am optimistic that we will recover these. And in fact, we have recovered the lows by more than 40-50% as I speak to you since the time the markets opened in the morning. And the feeling is that there is going to be stock-specific approach, sector-specific approach that is going to come into effect. Discovery of vaccine by Russia, of course, subject to certain scientific and medical clarity coming through, is a matter of something that we'll have to wait and watch. But even on the domestic front, I think there are a couple of companies which are already making some significant progress to find the cure for this virus that has emerged out of China. So I remain positive on the market. Maybe we might consolidate and have a little bit of profit booking. That is absolutely not ruled out. And as you are aware, every time we have made a higher low, we have managed to move up to a higher level. And this is a congestion zone, basically 11,250, 11,350. These are the two levels wherein you will see some congestion happening. But like I mentioned last time, since we have taken off 11,250, 11,300, and we are maintaining ourselves with some positive bias, I think slowly, steadily, we should see some consolidation coming and some buying also coming at lower level. Sectors and stock, I think IT remains to be in focus, though we saw a little bit of profit booking on pharma for the last couple of days. I think stock-specific approach should be maintained over there. Consumption-related stories will continue to hog the limelight. And my view is that one has to also keep on radar specialty chemicals and life insurance. So these are primarily some 4-5 sectors which large cap in mind we should possibly look at. On the rupee front, we are maintaining sub 75 against the dollar. And I think we should be going towards 74.50 or sub those levels as we see some amount of strength. There is some feeling that the dollar index might firm up, but I am quite optimistic that it is not going to be something significant. We will see strength coming back. So I don't see any major depreciation in rupee and appreciation in dollar. Maybe we might go towards 75, but in the next couple of days, we might go to 74.50. That is what my feeling is. On the gold prices, well, from 55,000 for 10 grams plus, we are trading with some quite sharp correction closer to 50,500. This is primarily yesterday when the COVID vaccine news came, the profit booking was much more severe. And not to forget, friends, we have seen tremendous, unstoppable rally, if I may use that word, on gold. So when you have these kind of rallies, you have profit booking also coming in. It's not surprising. But the longer term positive moves on gold remain intact. So please don't be wary of these kind of price correction from higher levels. It does happen when non-stop rallies are there on certain commodities, especially gold or even stock market related stories. So trade with a positive bias, and I'm quite sure that by the time I speak to you next week, we should be surpassing the hurdle of 11,350 and going towards 11,400-500, which you have spoken earlier. So trade with positive bias and keep this focus in mind. And for all those traders who have weak risk appetite, my humble request is try to book profits at higher level, or at least extend your profitable stop losses to a higher level so that you maximize on the profit. All the best and see you again next week. Take care. Bye-bye.